this woman to be married to this man?
I'm her father.
You may be seated.
Good luck.
David and Dana have come to offer themselves to each other in the holy bond of marriage. They recognize that marriage is a commitment in which nothing is held back, a pledge of mutual fidelity, and a partnership where the goal is to think together. This partnership, uniquely, is very important to me and is close to my heart. If you know David well, you know how much he loves this city, and Dana as well. I remember working where Dave would get off at 4 and just come spend time at 4 a.m. driving through the city. And to me, this is his town. He loves it. I remember it was in April 15, 2014. Dave and I rode motorcycles here with our friend Roger. But little did we know that 2 months later, Roger and I would be part of a different trip, as Roger helped contact emergency services. And shortly after, I got a call from Dave saying, guess where I am? I remember looking up and saying, I hope not in that helicopter. After the helicopter arrived, Dave had surgery on Tuesday. And on Thursday, June 29th, I posted on Facebook saying, if anyone gets the chance and wants to visit David, he was moved to the renowned rehabilitation hospital at 1496 Mills, just down the road from the main hospital. He's in room 132. Visiting hours are from 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. There's an extreme shortage of chairs in his room. There's just one. So if you got to bring back chair, bring it by. I know a lot of you in this room, I tag on that, especially those who lived in Reno, all of our coworkers. And one of those people had just moved to Reno. And 8 years ago, this girl responded saying, I want to come see you, David. Do you have any openings tomorrow? Maybe I can message you and see if it's a good time. I don't have any love sacks, though. And just like that, this love story started. I love this love story. And anyone that knows these two as the power couple that they are thankful that out of this horrible tragedy, one of the worst things that one can imagine, came one of the best things that we could possibly imagine, which ultimately led to this event that we're all blessed to be able to witness and celebrate today, this wedding. When I officiate weddings, I commonly give couples a worksheet, and I ask them to complete it separately. Dave was very open when I signed this to him, and I'm sure this doesn't come as a surprise to his mom, but he said, yeah, I don't want to do homework. But that's okay, because Dana told me that in this partnership, they think together. So I'm confident that Dana's answers are perfectly good enough for David. And I'm sure that David isn't surprised at all. When I asked her what she will receive out of marriage and what she wouldn't receive by remaining single, her answer was a new name and a tax write-off. I also don't think Dave will be surprised at all when she said the purpose of marriage is to always have a best friend to do cool shit with. She told me she's marrying David because he is her other half, that she never wants to be without him, and that he feeds her. She also said, David is marrying me because he loves me, he likes my butt, I keep the house clean, and we go on adventures. We have so much fun together. Dave actually finally turned his homework in last night. He told me that he is marrying Dana for companionship, love, building a life together, and pets. These two believe that marriage is more than a piece of paper and some signatures. It's love, it's compromise, it's support, it's picking up dirty socks from the bathroom floor. And it's to this special relationship that David and Dana now give themselves to one another. David, will you have Dana be your wedded wife? To live together in the bond of marriage, to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. Dana, will you have David be your wedded husband? To live together in the bond of marriage, to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him, as long as you both shall live. You go ahead and join each other's hand, face each other. Are you joining me?
After I had a pretty major life-altering experience. Dana was Father Lars, you put your family's well-being first, and that's the type of love is why I'm so lucky. Unless she's in the middle of the showroom.
We could talk about how rings make a circle, so they represent unending love, but so are hula hoops. We aren't exchanging hula hoops this evening. We could talk about how they're costly, made of precious metals, but so are cars, and these two don't have new ribbons. You get one another and get tickets in. Instead, I believe that these rings are powerful symbols that Dana and David have grown up their entire lives knowing about. Symbols that mean they're connected to someone else, but they aren't alone. Symbols that there is someone else deeply connected to them and involved in their life. They're a reminder not only to David and Dana of this commitment, but also to everyone else who sees them. David, would you please put this ring on Dana's finger and repeat after me? With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
I give it as a token of my love to you.
I give it as a token of my love to you.
And as a pledge of our enduring commitment. After me, with this ring, I be wed. I give it as a token of my love for you, and as a pledge of our enduring commitment. Since David and Dana have consented to join together in marriage, and have witnessed the same before all of you, and have pledged their mutual love to each other, and have declared the same by the giving and receiving of rings, I now declare their husband and wife. You may kiss the ring.